With the rise of the IoT, or Internet of Things, connected devices are becoming increasingly prevalent, including smartwatches, intelligent cars, connected surveillance systems, personal assistants, and of course, smartphones. As a result, the volume of data being generated is exploding. This massive amount of data risks overwhelming the bandwidth between these connected devices and the data centers that process the information. The result? Slower data processing, which can be a big problem in situations where we need to analyze and process data almost instantly. This is where edge computing offers a solution. Rather than transmitting all data to a remote data center for centralized processing, edge computing processes part of these massive data volumes locally and in a decentralized manner, either directly by the connected devices themselves or by a local machine, like a computer or a server. The immediate benefit is reduced latency, as data no longer needs to traverse a large network to reach a distant data center. This ultimately improves service quality. In this way, edge computing complements cloud computing. Each layer of the architecture has a specific role. IoT layer provides the human-machine interface. Connected devices generate, compress, and pre-process data before sending it to the edge layer. Edge layer handles data analysis, real-time processing, and caching. Cloud layer performs large-scale parallel data processing, such as big data or machine learning tasks. It also conducts global analysis of data from all devices and acts as a data warehouse for all connected devices. In summary, data requiring real-time responsiveness is processed locally at the edge. Less time-sensitive data is sent to the cloud for historical analysis, large-scale processing, and long-term storage. Let's see an example with autonomous vehicles. Autonomous vehicles rely on a multitude of connected devices, which generate vast amounts of data that need real-time processing. A prime example is the autopilot feature in vehicles. Sensors at the front and rear detect other vehicles. A video camera above the windshield identifies lane markings, traffic lights, and pedestrians. A GPS system and a laser-based radar analyze the surroundings, including obstacles. This critical data cannot afford to be sent to a data center for processing, especially if the vehicle is in an area with no network connectivity. Thus, critical data is processed locally, directly by an onboard supercomputer. All data generated by the vehicle's sensors are analyzed and processed by the onboard supercomputer, which is part of the edge. Some other data, like summary information about the vehicle's status, is sent to an intermediate edge server. Relevant data from the edge level is then transmitted to the data center, where it is analyzed globally and processed at scale. This enables the creation of predictive models to improve the vehicle's intelligence, which are then distributed back to all vehicles. If you enjoyed this video, hit that subscribe button to stay in the loop with my upcoming content, and don't hesitate to share it with anyone who might find it useful. See you soon!